Now we will discuss about types of follower motion. There are four types of follower motion, such as uniform velocity, simple harmonic motion, uniform acceleration and retardation motion, and cycloidal motion. Using this type of follower motion, according to syllabus, we need to solve the numericals in which we need to construct displacement diagram, velocity and acceleration diagrams, and the construction of cam profile. Here, I will take one example from uniform velocity motion. The problem is, a cam is to give the following motion to a knife-edged follower. Outstroke during 60 degree of cam rotation, dwell for the next 30 degree of cam rotation, return stroke during next 60 degree of cam rotation, and dwell for the remaining 210 degree of cam rotation. The stroke of the follower is 40 millimeter and the minimum radius of the cam is 50 millimeter. The follower moves with uniform velocity during both the outstroke and return strokes. Draw the profile of the cam when the axis of the follower passes through the axis of the camshaft, and B, the axis of the follower is offset by 20 millimeter from the axis of the camshaft. Determine the maximum velocity and acceleration of the follower when the cam rotates at 900 rpm. According to the given problem, we have to make sure what type of follower it contains. The given problem contains knife-edged follower, and outstroke angle 60 degree, first dwell period 30 degree, return stroke angle is 60 degree, the second dwell period is 210 degree. Stroke of the follower is given 40 millimeter. The minimum radius of the cam is given 50 millimeter. Nothing but base circle radius is given, that is 50 millimeter. Now, interestingly, the follower moves with uniform velocity during both outstroke and return strokes of the follower. Using this data, first we need to construct displacement diagram, velocity diagram, and acceleration diagram. Then, using the data from displacement diagram, we can construct the cam profile under two conditions. Number one, axis of the follower passing through the axis of camshaft. Option B, the axis of follower is offset by 20 millimeter from the axis of camshaft. Okay. So before to construct displacement diagram, we should select suitable scale. Dear students, keep in mind, we can construct the displacement diagram using plane sheets or graph sheets. So while taking dimensions along x and y axis, the scale is important. Now here, if I consider the dimensions along x axis, say 1 centimeter is equals to 20 degree. Along y-axis, 1 centimeter is equals to 10 millimeter. According to this considered scale, outstroke angle become 3 centimeter, nothing but 30 millimeter. Dwell angle become 1.5 centimeter, that is equals to 15 millimeter. Return stroke angle become 3 centimeter, that is equals to 30 millimeter. Remaining dwell period become 10.5 centimeter, that is equals to 105 millimeter. with this data, let me see what are the steps involved in the construction of displacement diagram under uniform velocity. Under step one, first, draw a line along the x-axis. The dimensions along the x-axis represents angle of rotation of the cam, that is in degrees. Along y-axis represents stroke or displacement of the follower. If we take dimensions along the x-axis from the origin, 30 millimeter represents outstroke, 60 degree rotation of cam. Next to 15 millimeter represents first dwell period for 30 degree. Next 30 millimeter represents return stroke for 60 degree. Next remaining 105 millimeter represents dwell for remaining 210 degree. The dimensions along the x-axis for one complete revolution of the cam we should take. Now along y-axis, we have to take dimension from stroke. Under step two, if we take dimensions along y-axis equal to stroke, that is 40 millimeter, according to the considered scale, it becomes 40 millimeter. Then close the box, it appears like rectangle from 40 mm along y to 360 degree rotation of cam along the x-axis. Close this box. That is step two. Step three. We need to divide outstroke angle and return stroke angle into any even number of equal parts. Any even number of equal parts. Say 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, like that. But because of selecting large number of even, we can get more accuracy in the construction of cam profile. Here, if I select that even number, say 6, once select the even number at beginning, till the completion of this problem, we should maintain that same even number. Now, after selecting even number, here, say 6, divide outstroke dimension and return stroke dimension into 6 equal parts. Then name the divisions from left to right during outstroke 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. During return stroke from left to right 6 dash, 5 dash, 4 dash, 3 dash, 2 dash, 1 dash, and 0 dash. This is belongs to step 3. Under step 4, after dividing outstroke and return stroke dimensions into 6 equal parts, through all these divisions, draw the vertical lines parallel to stroke up to 40 mm locus. Through 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 vertical lines up to 40 mm locus. From 6 dash, 5 dash, 4 dash, 3 dash, 2 dash, 1 dash, and 0 dash up to 40 mm locus. Step 5. Simply use proper tools. Join beginning of outstroke and end of outstroke with thick straight line. Next, during dwell period, join this end of outstroke and beginning of return stroke, nothing but beginning of first dwell and end of first dwell. Next, join beginning of return stroke and end of return stroke with thick straight line. Then the remaining for 105 millimeter, join with thick straight line from the end of return stroke to end of cam rotation. The meaning of this thick straight line during outstroke represents, this is the path of displacement of the follower during outstroke. It moves from bottom dead center to top dead center. during dwell period. The meaning of dwell during this period, follower become stable, whether it is at BDC or at TDC. Next, return stroke. During this period, the follower moves from top dead center to bottom dead center. So this is the path of the displacement of the follower during return stroke. For the next 210 degree of cam rotation represents second dwell period. During this period, the follower becomes stable at BDC. This is the method to construct the displacement diagram under uniform velocity. After this, under step 6, where at exactly this straight line intersect 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 vertical lines, mark that particular point, then name which sequence. If you take 0, that is the beginning point of outstroke represented by A, the first vertical line intersecting by this path at B, the second vertical line intersect at C, the third vertical line intersect at D, fourth vertical line intersect at E, fifth vertical line intersect at F, and sixth intersect at G. During dwell period, that is stable. Next, during return stroke, this path intersect sixth dash vertical line at H, fifth dash vertical line at J, fourth dash vertical line at K, three dash vertical line at L, two dash vertical line at M, one dash vertical line at N, and zero dash nothing but P. Zero dash coincide with P. Next, remaining angle of rotation of the cam is second dwell period up to Q. Now, this red path indicates this is the path of displacement of the follower during outstroke, first dwell period, return stroke, and second dwell period. Using the distance 1 to B, 2 to C, 3 to D, 4 to E, 5 to F, 6 to G, 6 dash to H, 5 dash to J, 4 dash to K, 3 dash to L, 2 dash to M, 1 dash to N. Using this vertical distance during outstroke and return stroke, we can construct cam profile under condition A and under condition B. Now under step 7, let me see how to construct the velocity and acceleration diagrams with reference to a displacement diagram under uniform velocity. Already we know how to construct the velocity diagram, the displacement diagram under uniform velocity. With reference to this displacement diagram, how to construct the velocity diagram? Before to construct this velocity diagram, we should take some reference lines with thick straight dashed lines. Number one, from the beginning of outstroke, drop a line up to some certain position. From the end of outstroke, drop a line up to some certain position. From the beginning of return stroke, from the end of return stroke, from the end of second dwell period. After that, we need to find maximum velocity during outstroke, maximum velocity during return stroke. The mathematical equation to determine maximum velocity during outstroke, it is the ratio of omega into S divided by theta suffix naught. So this value is constant. Omega represents angular velocity of cam. In the given problem, speed of cam is given, that is 900 rpm. Omega, nothing but 2 pi n by 60, is in radians per second. S represents stroke, that is 40 millimeter, convert to meter. Then divided by theta suffix naught represents angle of cam rotation during outstroke, that is 60 degree according to the given data. Now here we need to substitute this outstroke angle in terms of radians. Substitute this omega in radians per second. stroke in meter, then angle of rotation of cam during outstroke in radians. Now find the value for maximum velocity during outstroke in meter per second. Similarly, the maximum velocity during return stroke, the formula omega into s divided by angle of rotation of the cam during return stroke. Here also omega from the formula 2 pi n by 60, stroke in meter, angle of rotation of cam during return stroke, here that is 60 degree, convert to radians, substitute and find this value, that is also in meter per second. Once we know these values, at any convenient distance, draw a line horizontally along the x-axis from beginning to end of cam rotation. Then, as I told, these values become constant during outstroke and return stroke. During outstroke, so the upward motion represents the follower moves from bottom dead center to top dead center. So at beginning, velocity become maximum, then it become constant till the end of outstroke, and at the end of outstroke, it become zero. Then during dwell period, so this is the velocity of the follower, so it represents origin. Then at the beginning of return stroke, velocity is shows downward, that is equals to the maximum velocity during return stroke value. Then it become constant till the end of return stroke, then it become zero. Then during second dwell period of cam rotation, the velocity is comes along origin. Same way, here we have taken uniform velocity. So then there is no acceleration here. Then acceleration become zero during both outstroke and return stroke. This is the method to represent acceleration during outstroke and return stroke. So become infinity. Dear students, now we will see how to construct the cam profile. According to the given problem, the condition A says the axis of the follower passes through the axis of the camshaft. Now before to construct this cam profile under this condition, first we should make sure what is the base circle radius. According to the given problem, the minimum radius of the cam is given, that is 50 millimeter. Use proper tools, draw a circle of radius 50 millimeter. Then mark the CG of this circle. This circle, nothing but base circle. Find the CG of the base circle, call it as O. Then through point O, draw a line vertically upward with thin straight axis line up to some certain position. Where at exactly this axis line intersects the base circle, mark that point, call it as zero. Next, according to condition A, the axis of the follower passing through the axis of the cam. With reference to this vertical axis line, then from the point zero, show the shape of the knife-edged follower. In the given problem, it contains knife-edged follower. To construct this knife-edged follower, scale is not required, but use proper tools. Up to some certain height, draw this knife-edged follower. Next, join point O and zero with thin straight line. Next, we need to make sure whether the cam rotating in clockwise sense or in counterclockwise sense. But in the given problem, he did not mention. Then the choice is yours. Suppose here, if I consider the cam rotates in clockwise sense, if the cam rotates in clockwise sense, okay, then we need to mark the angle of rotation of the cam with reference to this zero O path towards counterclockwise sense. Here, use proper tools. As the center of O, as a center of O with reference to O0 in counterclockwise sense, draw a line at an angle 60 degree represents outstroke angle. Then from the end of outstroke angle, mark another 30 degree represents first dwell period. From the end of first dwell, mark another 60 degree represents return stroke. Then the remaining 210 degree represents second dwell period. Like this, we need to mark outstroke, first dwell, return stroke angle from O zero path in counterclockwise sense. Next, at the beginning of this problem, particularly while constructing displacement diagram, we have selected one of the even number, that is 6. Till the end of this problem, we should maintain that same even number. After this step, here, we need to divide the outstroke angle and return stroke angle into 6 equal parts. On the circumference of the base circle, divide this angle into 6 equal parts, then name the divisions. So from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 equal parts. Similarly, divide the complete return stroke angle into 6 equal parts. Then on the circumference of the base circle, name these divisions like 6 dash, 5 dash, 4 dash, 3 dash, 2 dash, 1 dash, and 0 dash. After dividing this outstroke angle, return stroke angle into 6 equal parts, and after naming the divisions on the circumference of base circle, next, we need to extend these paths up to some certain positions, from all the divided points up to some certain position. Then after this, so from the displacement diagram, we need to measure the vertical distance. A is the beginning point that is coincide at 0. The vertical distance from 1 to B, 2 to C, 3 to D, 4 to E, 5 to F, 6 to G. Again from during return stroke, 6 dash to H, 5 dash to J, 4 dash to K, 3 dash to L, 2 dash to M, 1 dash to N, then P coincide at 0 dash. Using compass or scale, we can measure this vertical distance. From this displacement diagram, with reference to this vertical distance, we can mark the intersecting points at cam profile. With continuation, with reference to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, during outstroke, mark this intersecting points, the distance 1 to B, 2 to C, 3 to D, 4 to E, 5 to F, 6 to G from the displacement diagram. Similarly, during return stroke, with reference to 6 dash to H, 5 dash to J, 4 dash to K, 3 dash to L, 2 dash to M, 1 dash to N, then P coincide at 0 dash. Then next, we need to join all these intersecting points from 0, nothing but A to B to C, D, E, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, P with thick parabolic arc. Then again from 0 dash to 0, nothing but P to A. So this is the remaining cam profile. It comes along base circle. So this red color path indicates this is the actual shape of the cam. So this cam profile, if we consider from the beginning of this point, the first 60 degree rotation in clockwise sense raise the follower from BDC to TDC. Next 30 degree, so this period, so retains the follower at top dead center. Next 60 degree rotation of the cam during return stroke, it lowers the follower from TDC to BDC. But remaining 210 degree of the cam rotation represent, it retains the follower at BDC till the end of first rotation of the cam. So this is the method to construct the cam profile according to condition A. Next, let me see how to construct the cam profile when the axis of the follower is offset by 20 millimeter from the axis of the camshaft. First step, we need to construct base circle. Already we know that how to construct the base circle of radius 50 millimeter, nothing but the minimum radius of the cam, that is 50 millimeter. Use proper tools, draw a circle of radius 50 millimeter, represents base circle. Next, under this condition, we need to construct one more circle, that is called half set circle, with reference to half set distance. Use proper tools, take point O as center. So this is the CG of the base circle. With reference to CG of the base circle, draw a circle of radius 20 millimeter. So this is called half set circle. Next step, here we need to make sure axis of the follower is half set at a distance of 20 millimeter from the axis of camshaft, nothing but from the point O. Here, tangent to this offset circle, draw a line vertically with thin straight axis line up to some certain position. Here also, where at exactly this axis line intersects the base circle, mark that point, call it as zero. With reference to zero and this vertical line, show the shape of the knife edged follower with proper tools up to some certain height. Next, similarly here, join O and zero with thin straight line. Then make sure the cam rotating in clockwise or in counterclockwise sense. Here we are considering in clockwise sense. If it is in clockwise sense, with reference to O zero path, in counterclockwise sense, mark the outstroke angle, then the first dwell period, then next return stroke angle. Return stroke angle. Now the remaining 210 degree represents the second dwell period. So this is the outstroke angle, first dwell period, the return stroke angle up to the base circle. Next step, we need to divide this outstroke angle and return stroke angle into six equal parts up to the circumference of the base circle. On the circumference of the base circle, divide this outstroke angle and return stroke angle into six equal parts. Then name the divisions like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. During return stroke, 6 dash, 5 dash, 4 dash, 3 dash, 2 dash, 1 dash, and 0 dash. In the next step, so be careful. The before to mark this intersecting point, through all these divisions, during outstroke and during return stroke, we need to draw the lines tangent to this half set circle. Suppose if you take through Z, zero already is there, that is axis line, it becomes tangent to the half set circle. Next, through the point one, draw a line tangent to the half set circle and extend that path up to some certain position. Along this path, we need to mark B from the point one. Here, the distance from one to B, that is from the displacement diagram. So one to B. Next, through point two, draw a line tangent to half set circle, extend that path up to some certain position. With reference to two, mark distance two to C from the displacement diagram. Again, through three, draw a line tangent to the half set circle, extend that path up to some certain position. Then with reference to three, mark distance between three to D. So this distance from displacement diagram. Similarly, through four, first draw a line tangent to half set circle, Then extend that path from 4, mark E. Then through 5 and through 6 also, similarly, draw the tangent lines, tangent to half set circle, extend those paths up to some certain position. With reference to 5, mark F. With reference to 6, mark G. This distance from the displacement diagrams. Similarly, during return stroke, through all these divisions, draw the tangent lines, tangent to the half set circle, and extend these paths up to some certain position from the displacement diagram with reference to 6 dash, mark H, 5 dash to J, 4 dash to K, 3 dash to L, 2 dash to M, 1 dash to N, then P coincide at 0 dash. Next step, join all these intersecting points from A to B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, sorry, I is not there, H, J, K, L, M, N, P. Join all these intersecting points with thick parabolic arc. Then remaining 210 degree represents the second dwell period. So simply, point O as center, draw a circle from 0 dash to 0 on the base circle. So this red color path indicates this is the actual path of the cam circumference. So this red color shape indicates cam profile. Here also, when the cam rotates in clockwise sense, the first 60 degree rise the follower from BDC to TDC. Next 30 degree, it remains the follower at TDC. Next 60 degree rotation of the cam, it lowers the follower from TDC to BDC. Remaining 210 degree of cam rotation, it retains the follower at BDC. So like this, the relative motion takes place between the cam and follower when the cam rotates in clockwise sense. So this is the method to construct the cam profile under condition A and condition B. I hope you understand how to construct the cam profile according to the given condition.